Hi friends, welcome to Amrita IAS Academy. My name is Balakrishna. I take history classes for you. So then, today we have to discuss what syllabus is there for this Group 1 prelims examination. So here, notification that is expected. They are going to give calendar that is on May 30th like that. So IPPSA announced, okay, government announced. So regarding that, you have to prepare for Group 2 as well as Group 1. First, we have to see this Group 1 examination, prelims point of view. What syllabus is there in history, that we are going to discuss. So, you see first, so here history. From history, how many marks we can expect? 20 to 25 marks will come from history. So, we can expect sometimes 20 marks, sometimes 25 marks we can get from history. For this, your preparation must be good. Everything is possible, you know well. Each and everything is possible. Sometimes, you may think that Group 1 is not possible for me. Okay. It is beyond me like that you may feel. No, don't feel like that. You have every quality or qualification to get Group 1 services. Okay. It all depends on your energies, your hard work, your concentration, your patience. So, all these are necessary for that. Basically, consistency, that is also important. Clarity about the syllabus, that is important. Continuity is very, very important. First of all, you have to get clarity about the syllabus. What syllabus is there that you have to get clarity? So, coming to this examination, history plays very important role, you know well. So, in connection with that, we have to see what important areas they are asked for this Group 1 prelims examination, that we have to see. Okay. So, you see, first topic, if you see this one, so, one is Indus Valley Civilization. So, here, Indus Valley Civilization, that's one of the important areas. So, that's asked in the examination. History and culture, that's our topic. History and culture, that's our topic. In this topic, especially what happened? So, first topic is Indus Valley Civilization. So, this is Indus Valley Civilization. Begins with Indus Valley Civilization. Indus Valley Civilization, excavations, they were started in the year 1921. Under Sir John Marshall. Sir John Marshall, he was an archaeologist, you know well. So, previously, prior to 1921, Indians believed that no civilization started in India. In India, civilization started with Aryans. But after excavations, after diggings, okay. So, one of the important and noblest civilization came to light is Indus Valley Civilization. Many sites came to light beside the river Indus. That's why it is called Indus Valley Civilization. Then we have to see in this. So, in the year 1921 only excavations they were started to this Indus Valley Civilization as Sir John Marshall. So, we have to see what features are there for this. What important sites are there? What important sites? Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, Chenhu-daro, Kalibangan, Lothal, Banwali, okay. Surkatoda, Sutkajenda, Ropar, Rangapur, Rakhi Garhi, Dholavira, like that. Which is the biggest site in India? Among all the sites which were identified or discovered in India, which is the biggest site in India? Rakhi Garhi. Rakhi Garhi is the biggest site in India, we can say. Among all the sites of Indus Valley, because some sites came to light in Pakistan, some sites came to light in India. In this especially, okay, you have to identify sites. What sites are there? How society? Whether it is matriarchal society, patriarchal society, history, so there's art and religion. So, all these areas we have to see. How the seals are made by them. Seals are made of steatite. Seals are made of steatite only. Pottery that was well established by them. Okay, like that, each and everything, social conditions, economic conditions, religious conditions, what things they worshipped, what things are found in different places. So, all these we are going to see in Indus Valley Civilization, right? Indus Valley Civilization. It is also called Harappan Civilization. Otherwise, it is also called Bronze Age Civilization. Bronze Age Civilization. Or we are calling Ancient Civilization. Ancient Indian Civilization. So, like that, that is one of the important. After that, the Vedic Age we have to see. Vedic Age we are calling. This Vedic Age that began in the year 1500. So, that began in the year 1500 BC and continued till 600 BC. So, this Vedic Age we are calling, Vedic Age began in the year 1500. One is early Vedic we are calling, one is later Vedic we are calling. Early Vedic started in the year 1500 and continued till 1000 BC. Later Vedic started in 1000 and continued till 600. We have to see all the sources. Vedas, Vedangas, Upavedas, Upanishads, Itihasas, at the same time Shaddarshanas. So like that, all these sources we have to see for this Vedic civilization. Early Vedic, later Vedic. How society that advanced in the Vedic period, that we have to see. Social conditions, economic conditions, religious conditions, all the conditions of Vedic society, we have to discuss. Then we have to see this Mahajanapadas. Janapada we are calling. So marriage is the source of family. Suppose if they want to establish family, there must be marriage. If they get marriage, then they will establish family. Family becomes source. Okay. Some families came together and they established a village. Some villages came together, they called that one as vis. Some vises came together and established Janapada. So if it is a big one, then it is called Mahajanapadas. Shodasha Mahajanapadas. Mahajanapada is a state. Mahajanapada is nothing but state we are calling. How many Mahajanapadas they existed in India during that time, in ancient society, ancient period? Okay, so you know well. So there is society, in ancient society, 16 Mahajanapadas existed. So this Mahajanapadas we are calling. Anga, Kasi, Kosala, Magadha, Chedi, Vatsa, Kuru, Panchala, Asmaka, Avanti, Vajji, Malla, Surasena. Okay, like that. So here what happened? 16 Mahajanapadas we had to see. After that religion, Jainism and Buddhism. In 6th century BC only, Jainism and Buddhism emerged. Because of unrest in Hindu religious systems. Okay. Karmakandas, yagnas, animal sacrifices, so etc. they started. For a common people, it is not possible to perform all those, to observe all those. At this moment only what happened? Jainism and Buddhism. Religious unrest entered in the minds of people. At that moment, Jainism and Buddhism, what they said is, just if you follow certain principles, you are going to get mukti, moksha, like that. So they came to force. In Jainism, there are 24 Tirthankaras. Are there, you know well. Jainism. Rishabhanatha was the first one. 23rd one, Parshvanatha. 24th one, Vardhamana Mahavira. Like that, Jainism, that's one. After that, Buddhism also you have to see. So Buddhism. This Gautama Buddha is considered to be the founder of Buddhism. Gautama Buddha. Original name Siddhartha. Okay. So like that, Buddhist principles we have to see. Arya Satyas we are calling otherwise four noble truths. World is full of sorrows and sufferings. World is full of wherever you go. We think that he is very rich man, but we also have some sorrows and sufferings. World is full of sorrows and sufferings. Desire is the cause of sorrows and sufferings. One can come out of sorrows and sufferings. One should follow Ashtanga Marga. All this will come in Buddhism. What are the holy books of Buddhism? Tripitakas. Tripitakas are the holy books of Buddhism. That you have to know. Like that, one area we have to see is Jainism and Buddhism. That's one of the. So this empire, this one. Then Magadha Empire. So this Magadhas. So this not Magadhas, Magadha Empire we have to see. So this is called, how in the sense, this is called Magadha Empire. Okay, Magadha Empire we are calling, Magadha, so DHA, Magadha Empire, the Mauryas, foreign inventions like that. Magadha that is advanced, among all the Shodasha Mahajanapadas, this Magadha comes in Bihar region, that advanced and occupied almost many regions. Magadha Empire we are calling, Haryanka Dynasty, Sisunaga Dynasty, so Nanda Dynasty, all these dynasties administered, Magadha Empire, that you have to know. After that, Mauryan Empire. Chandragupta Maurya is considered to be the founder of Mauryan Empire. Very vast empire. Big empire that was established by Chandragupta Maurya. Kashmir to last Tamil Nadu region, he established an empire. And Baluchistan to Bihar, empire was established by Chandragupta Maurya. So then after Bindusara, we have to see. Then Ashoka. Ashoka the great, we are calling, right? Like that, Mauryan Empire, that is one. Then foreign invasions on India and their impact. Foreign invasions, if you see, Alexander attacked India. Alexander attacked India in the year 326. He came in the year 327 BC, but Battle of Jhelum or Battle of Hydaspes. Battle of Jhelum, otherwise we are calling Battle of Hydaspes, that took place in the year 326 BC. Alexander versus Porus, Purushottam we are calling Punjab ruler. At last he was defeated, Alexander got victory. Like that, we have to see all foreign invasions. Foreign invasions also, that's one. In that, especially Kushans. Kushan dynasty, Kanishka was the greatest ruler. It was started by Kuzla Kodphises. After that, Vima Kodphises. Then Kanishka was the greatest ruler in that dynasty, we can say, in Kushan dynasty. He was the greatest ruler, Kanishka. He came to power in the year 78 AD and continued till 102 AD. Kanishka. So, Devaputra, Caesar. So, he was called second Ashoka, like that. Titles they are there to this Kanishka. We have to see that important one. After that, South Indian dynasty, Shatavahanas. They are called Shatavahanas, or they are also called Salivahana. They are called Shatakarnis. Different names are there to these Shatavahanas. They were the people who administered Andhra Desha for 450 years. Three capitals they existed to Shatavahanas. One is Pratisthanapura or Paichan, that was capital. Second capital, Dhanyakataka, otherwise Dharanikota. Today we are calling Amaravati. And third capital, Srikakulam. Srikakulam, not present district. Srikakulam town that existed in Krishna district, that was the capital of this Shatavahanas. Like that, Shatavahana empire started with Sri Mukha Shatavahana. Then Krishna Shatavahana, Shatakarni 1, Purnotsunga, Skandastambi, Shatakarni 2. Like that, how many rulers are there? 30 rulers are there in that dynasty. You know, the greatest ruler, Gautami Putra Shatakarni, 23rd ruler in that dynasty, Gautami Putra Shatakarni. Like that, so that's one. Then Sangam is Vahatu. Sangam literature, Tamil literature that is called. In the period of Chera, Chola, Pandya. Chera's period, Chola's period, Pandya's period. Pandya's capital, Madurai. Chera capital, Vanji. Okay. And Chola's capital, Tanjore or Tanjavur. In the period of these rulers, this Tamil literature, Tamil language, they advanced. Okay. Pandita Parishad, that is called Sangam. Sangam literature, Sangam is that was started. So, then after, we have to see these Sungas. Sunga dynasty. Pushyamitra Sunga, he was the founder of Sunga dynasty. He was a Brahmin. First time Brahmins came to power. Profession change that took place here. Sungas, we are calling. Sunga dynasty. Pushyamitra Sunga. Okay. So, there is so Pushyamitra Sunga, Agnimitra. So, like that here, Sungas we have to see. After that, we have to see this Gupta Empire. Okay. You know, in the world, three ages are called golden ages. Golden periods like that. Okay. So, in India, Gupta's period, Chandragupta's period is called Golden Age. All round development that took place in the period of this Chandragupta too. So, not only in one field, in many fields development that took place. Hence, we are calling this Chandragupta's period, that is Golden Age. Okay. Sri Gupta was the founder of this one. He was also called Chilikito. After that, Ghatotkaja Gupta, he came to power. Then Chandragupta I, Samudragupta. Okay, Ramagupta, Chandragupta II. Like that, so here, Chandragupta II's period is called Golden Age. Okay, so like that, so there is especially, that's one of the important areas we have to see. Because literature, art and architecture, astronomy, astrology, all these developed in the period of these Guptas only. Okay, so there is especially, so in the period of this one only, what happened? So Aryabhatta lived. Aryabhattiyam, Surya Siddhanta, they were the books written by Aryabhatta. How this earth turns round the sun, moves round the sun, revolves round the sun, that was said by Aryabhatta. Decimal system, said by Aryabhatta. Solar eclipse, lunar eclipse, they were said by Aryabhatta. Like that, many things are said by Aryabhatta. Aryabhattiyam, this one. Surya Siddhanta, this one, they were the books. Brahmagupta, he wrote Brahmasputa Siddhanta. Brahmasputa Siddhanta said about the gravitational force of the earth. It said about what? Gravitational force. That's why he was called Indian Newton. Brahmagupta is called like that. We had medical sciences. Well advanced in the period of these Guptas. Medical sciences. Shushruta. Shushruta Samhita. Palakapya, Ashtayurveda. So then, okay, Ashtanga Sangraha, like the number of books came to light in the period of this one. So Shruta Samhita mainly said about so cataract operations, eye operations. It indicates that technology, medical sciences advanced well. Like that, each and everything we have to see. So in Guptas, especially their administration, social conditions, religious conditions, economic conditions, art and architecture, literature, science and technology, all these areas we have to see, not only in Guptas, in all these areas. Like that, this is all first chapter. This is all first chapter that you have to remember. After this one, second chapter we have to see. Coming to second chapter, the canoes, they and their contribution, canoes and their contribution, South Indian dynasties. So that's the area we have to see, Kanaus. So this Kanaus became the capital of this Harshavardhana. He was the last greatest Hindu ruler who administered complete North India. Even though he was the greatest ruler, but he was defeated in the hands of Pulakesi II in 619 AD, beside the river Narmada, right? Like that, Kanaus and their contributions, that we have to see. South Indian dynasties, that we have to see. In that, South Indian dynasties, Badami Chalukyas. In Karnataka, Badami became the capital. That's why they are called Badami Chalukyas. We are calling Badami Chalukyas. Then Eastern Chalukyas. In the eastern side only, they established this way. They are called Eastern Chalukyas. Otherwise, Vingi Chalukyas we are calling. Badami Chalukyas, greatest ruler, Pulakesi II. Aihole inscription said about Pulakesi II, right? Eastern Chalukya Sifiti, Gunaga Vijayaditya, he was the greatest ruler. It was started by Eastern Chalukyan Empire, that was started by Kubja Vishnu Vardhana, brother of Pulakesi II, right? So like that, we have to see Eastern Chalukyas. Then, Rashtrakutas, that's also one important area. Danti Durga was the founder of Rashtrakuta Empire. Danti Durga. Okay. So this previously Ellora, otherwise Ellara or Elichpur, that was the capital of Rashtrakutas. After that, they shifted capital to Manyakheta. Okay. Amoghavarsha, one of the important rulers. Kaviraja Marga, that was a book written by Amoghavarsha, who belongs to Rashtrakutas. Manyakheta became the capital. Today it is called Manukota, located in Karnataka. Right? Like that, that's one. Then Kalyani Chalukyas. Kalyani became the capital. That's why they are called Kalyani Chalukyas. One is Badami Chalukyas. One is Vingi Chalukyas or Eastern Chalukyas. One is Kalyani Chalukyas. That's a small topic that also we have to see. After that, the Cholas. Okay. Hayasalas. The Adavas. All these we have to. Cholas of Tanjavur. Rajaraja Chola. Rajendra Chola. Brihadishwara temple that was established by Rajaraja Chola. 1000 years over. So our Reserve Bank of India gave 1000 rupees coin. So in memory of this Brihadishwara temple, it is not in circulation. This coin is not in circulation, only in memory. Okay, 1000 rupees coin, you see. We can see 1 rupee coin, 2 rupees coin, 5 rupees, 10 rupees like that. But 1000 rupees coin given by RBI in memory of this Brihadishwara temple, which was established by Rajaraja Chola. Right, like the Cholas. Then Hayasala Empire. Hayasala's capital, Dwarasamudra. Dwarasamudra, that was the capital, we have to see Hayasala's. Okay, then Yadavas. So this Yadavas, that is another important area that also we have to see. Yadavas. Okay. This Yadavas, that's one. Yadava kingdom. Yadavas of Devagiri we are calling. Yadavas capital is Devagiri. So today Devagiri, that was named as Aurangabad. This Devagiri, that is famous. So in the period of Yadavas. Yadava Ramachandra Deva. Okay, but accepted the authority of Alauddin Khilji. Like that, that all. Even Kakatiyas went against Yadavas. Kakatiyas went against Yadavas. Yadavas ruler Jaitrapala, he only killed so this Rudradeva. At the same time, Rudradeva's brother Mahadeva, he was also lost in the hands of Yadavas. Like that, Yadavas. Then Kakatiyas of Warangal. Kakatiyas of Warangal, that also we have to see. They came in the year 1000 and continued till 1323, that you know well. This Kakatiya empire that was started in the year 1000, according to some sources, 1008. Some sources said 995 AD. Some sources said 995. 995 only, this Kakatiyas came like that. They continued till 1323 AD. Okay. The last ruler, Prataparudrachu. Greatest ruler, Ganapati Deva. Ganapati Deva's daughter, Rudramadevi. Rudramadevi came to power with the name Rudradeva Maharaja. With that title only, she came to power. Okay. We have to see all important. Early Kakatiyas are 5 in number. Later Kakatiyas, 5 in number. Kakatiya Empire, early Kakatiyas, Betarazu 1, Prolarazu 1, Betarazu 2, Durgarazu, Prolarazu 2. These are the rulers. Later Kakatiyas, Rudradeva, Mahadeva, Ganapati Deva, Rudramadevi, Pratapa Rudra 2. These are the rulers. Like that one. Then Reddy Kingdom. Reddy's capital, Addanki. Addanki became the capital of Reddy Kingdom. So that we have to see. Prolaya Vema Reddy. Ana Potha Reddy, Ana Vema Reddy, Kumaragiri Reddy, Racha Vema Reddy, Addanki. After that, Rajamundry Reddy Kingdom, that also we have to see. Like that. So these are the areas which are asked in second chapter for prelims. Prelim point of view. So each and everything that is important. Because if we qualify prelims, then only there is possibility to appear main examination. Without qualifying prelims, it is not possible to appear mains. So that's why you have to prove your capacity in prelims examination first. After that only mains. Then after that personality test or interview. Right? So like that, second chapter deals with all these areas. You have to remember. Then coming to third chapter, what areas are there in third one? Delhi Sultanate, one of the important area. So that is asked here is, Delhi Sultanate, that's one of the important ones. Okay. So, Delhi Sultanate we are calling. Okay. Which one? Delhi Sultanate. Delhi Sultanate that was started in the year 1206 and continued till 1526. 1206 and 1526, that is of Delhi Sultanate in that Slave Dynasty, Khilji Dynasty, Tughlaq Dynasty, Sayyid Dynasty, Lodi Dynasty. These are the dynasties we have to see. Right? So, here, Delhi Sultanate, that is one of the important area. So, that's one area we have to see. So, Delhi Sultanate we are calling. Delhi became the capital. So, that's why Delhi Sultanate we are calling. So, okay. They started in the year 1206 and continued till 1526. 1206. And continued till 1526. That is of Delhi Sultanate. Then, Vijayanagar Empire. This was started in the year 1336. Continued till 1680. That's the period of this Vijayanagar Empire. Vijayanagar Empire that was administered by so four dynasties. Sangama, Saluva, Tuluva, Aravithi dynasties administered this one. You have to remember. Sangama, Saluva, Tuluva, Aravithi dynasties. Especially this Sri Krishna Devarayalu belongs to Tuluva dynasty. 1509-1529, that's the period of Sri Krishna Devarayalu. Greatest ruler, and he was the richest ruler during that time in the country. Per day income, that was 12,000 rupees. Per day income during that time, 12,000 rupees. Like that, he was the greatest ruler. So, it's called Andhra Bhoja. Andhra Bhoja. Because he liked Telugu literature very much and Telugu language very much. Andhra Bhoja. Muru Rayaraganda. Three regions were under this administered by this one. Hence, it was called Muru Rayaraganda. Yavana Rajya Sthapanacharya. Sangeeta Sahitya Samarangana Sarvabhauma. So, literature, art and architecture, all these developed in the period of this one. Astadikajas lived in the court of Sri Krishna Devarayalu, you know well. In Telugu language, he wrote Amukta Malyada. In Sanskrit, Madalasa Charitra, Jambavati Parinayam, Usha Parinayam, Satyavadu Parinayam, Jnana Chintamani, all these are written by the Sri Krishna Devarayalu. Right? You have to remember, Astadikajas. Eight poets lived in the court of Sri Krishna Devarayalu. In that Allasani Peddana, Nandi Timmana, Madayagari Mallana, Durjeti, Ayala Raja Ramabhadra, Tenali Ramakrishna, Bhattu Murthy, Pingali Surana. These are the poets. Books are asked in the examination. You have to remember the books. Allasani Peddana wrote the book Manucharitra. Manucharitra is also called Swarochisa Manusambhavam. Okay, Nandi Timmana Parijata Paharanam, Madayagari Mallana Rajashekara Charitra, Durjati Sri Kalahastishwara Mahatyam శ్రీ కాళహస్తీశ్వర శతకం. అయ్యల రాజు రామభద్ర రామాభ్యుదయం దట్ వాజ్ రిటన్ బై దిస్. తెనాలి రామకృష్ణ పాండురంగ మహత్యం ఉద్భటారాధ్య చరిత్ర భట్టుమూర్తి ఓకే వసు చరిత్ర ఓకే లైక్ దాట్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు నో ద బుక్స్ ఆల్సో రైట్. విజయనగర ఎంపైర్ దట్స్ వెరీ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ దేర్ కండిషన్స్ ఆర్ట్ అండ్ ఆర్కిటెక్చర్ లిటరేచర్ ఆల్ దీస్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు సీ. దెన్ Mughal Empire, that is also important. Mughal Empire that was started in the year 1526 with this Babo, Jahiruddin Muhammad Babur, who started this Mughal Empire. Mughal Empire that was started by Jahiruddin Muhammad Babur, that's one of the important things. Then Bhakti movement and Sufi movement. Bhakti movement that was started in Hinduism, Sufi movement that was started in Islam. Bhakti, so especially Advaita philosophy. సో ద్వైత ఫిలాసఫీ, విశిష్టాద్వైత ఫిలాసఫీ, సో దే శుద్ధాద్వైత ఫిలాసఫీ, ద్వైతాద్వైత ఫిలాసఫీ, లైక్ దట్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు సీ ఆల్ దీస్. ఓకే, సో దే ఆది శంకరాచార్య, రామానుజాచార్య, మధ్వాచార్య, సో ఆల్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ దే భక్తి సైన్స్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు సీ. నాట్ ఓన్లీ దట్ వన్ గురునానక్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు సీ, కబీర్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు, రామానంద వీ హ్యావ్ టు సీ, ఓకే చైతన్య మహాప్రభు, లైక్ దట్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు సీ. భక్తి Sufism we are calling, Silsilas we have to see. Okay, Chisti order, Khadri order, okay, Naksabandi order, like that we have to see what important points are there in that. So Sufism, Sufi is a word derived from Safa, Safa means holy, holy. Bhakti is a word derived from base, Sanskrit word base, base means devotion to personal God, okay, like that. So here we have to see administration, economy, society, religion, literature. Related with all these, Delhi Sultanate literature we have to see, Vijayanagar Empire literature, art and architecture. So all these, Mughal Empire art and architecture, like that. So economy, society, religion, art and architecture, all these, they are coming in this topic. Then coming to fourth chapter, if you see, European trading companies, the European trading companies in India, they struggle for supremacy. So, special reference to Bengal, Bombay, Madras, Mysore, Andhra and Nizam, Governor Generals and Viceroys. These are all the topics we have to see in connection with this one. European trading companies. Who were the first people to come to India? Europeans. The Portuguese. Second one, the Dutch. Third one, the British. Fourth one, Danes or Danish. Last one, the French. Like that, they people came to India for the purpose of trade and commerce. In that, especially Britain only, the British only advanced. They only established their supremacy and power in India. That you have to. The struggle for supremacy with special reference to Bengal, Bombay and Madras. In all these regions, who established power? The British only established their supremacy or power. In Bengal, okay. So there's Bombay, Madras. Then Mysore, we have to see. So there's Anglo-Mysore Wars, we have to see. So Andhra under Nizams. Okay, Nizams. So Asaf Jahi dynasty administered. So from Nizam Ali Khan's period only they are called Nizams. We have to see all these. Mysore, Andhra and Nizam, that is in the areas. After that, Governor Generals and Viceroys, we have to see. You know, 1773 to 1857, we are calling them Governor Generals. 15 Governor Generals, they are there. After that, 20 Viceroys are there. 1858 to 1947, they are called Viceroys. 1773 to 1857, they are called Governor Generals. First Governor General, Lord Warren Hastings. Lord Warren Hastings. Last Governor General, Lord Canning. First Viceroy, Lord Canning. Last Viceroy, Lord Mountbatten. So, 15 Governor Generals we have to see. So, 20 Viceroys also. Sometime, the question may be asked, whose period? INC that was started. Who was the Viceroy during that time? Lord Dufferin. Who was called father of civil services? Lord Cornwallis. Who is called father of local civil government? Lord Ripon. Okay. Who was the Sardis Viceroy who lost life in India? Lord Mayo. He was stabbed and killed when he visited Andaman Nicobar Jail. Like that, some questions may be asked from this. Who introduced the subsidiary alliance? Lord Wellesley. Who was the first Indian to join subsidiary alliance? Subsidiary alliance, that is Nizam Ali Khan. Like that, Governor Generals we have to see, Viceroys also we have to see. That is one of the important area that we have to remember. Everything lies in hard work. There is no shortcut for success, only hard work. If you do hard work, 100% you will come out successfully. Okay, that's very, very important. Right then. So next one, so fifth chapter. So if you see this fifth chapter, Indian War of Independence. Indian War of Independence as 1857 war we are calling. Otherwise, Indian War of Independence. So that's in the year 1857. Indian War of Independence, 1857. 1857 Sepoys Mutiny. What are the causes of the outbreak of this Sepoys Mutiny? What comments are there? Who commented that? It is Hindu-Muslim conspiracy against the British. Hindu-Muslim conspiracy against the British. It is said by Outram and Taylor. Who called this as a great rebellion? Ashok Mehta. Who called First War of Indian Independence? V.D. Savarkar. Who called this one as a war between civilized and uncivilized? T.R. Holmes. Okay. So like that, you have to see all the comments and who are the leaders in different places. That is asked in Mass of Following. In Mass of Following only, that question that was asked. Okay. Who are the leaders in Rajasthan, in Odisha, in Delhi, in Kanpur, in Bareilly, in Assam, like that, in Hyderabad. So leaders, all the leaders, you have to know. Okay. So Jai Dayal Singh, Hardayal Singh, they are the leaders in Rajasthan. Ujjwal Sahi, Surendra Sahi, they are leaders in Odisha. Okay. Leaders in Odisha. So in Delhi, Bahadur Shah II and Bhakta Khan, they were the leaders. Okay. In Lucknow, Begum Hazrat Mahal. In Kanpur, Nana Sahib, Tantiya Tope. Jhansi, Jhansi Lakshmi Bai. Like that, each and every point you have to see related with this 1857 revolt. Origin, nature, causes, consequences, significance with the connected states. Okay. So 1857 revolt. What causes are there for the outbreak of this one? How it originated? What causes are there? Consequences are there? So special reference concerned states. Even in Andhra, how it was started, that also you have to. Religious and social reform movements, next round. Religious movements and social reform movements. What religious movements are they? Social reform movements are they here? Social reform movements, if you see, Raja Ramu Mohan Roy, Brahma Samaj. Brahma Samaj, that was in the year 1828. Young Bengal movement, 1829, Henry Vivian D'Arrosio. Then, Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar, we have to see. Because he was the first one to perform widow remarriage, right? Then, so this 1867 Prarthana Samaj Atmaram Pandranga, 1873 Satya Shodak Samaj Mahatma Jyotirao Phule, then 1875 Arya Samaj Swami Dayananda Saraswati, 1875 Theosophical Society Madam H.P. Blavatsky and Colonel Olcott, okay, Deccan Education Society 1884. So, Muslim Education Society, 1886. Ramakrishna Mission, 1897. So, like that, you have to see. Ramakrishna Mission by Swami Vivekananda. It is in the year 1897. Belur, that was the headquarters. Birthday of Swami Vivekananda celebrated as January 12th. January 12th is celebrated as National Youth Day. You have to remember. Who changed the name of Narendranath Datta as Swami Vivekananda? Khetri Maharaj Ajit Singh. Okay, the name of Vivekananda, especially original name. So there is Narendranath Datta. Bhuvaneshwari Devi, Vishwanath Datta were the parents of this Swami Vivekananda. Right? You have to know all important Samaj, social reform movements we are calling. Religious and social reform movements, that's when 19th century in India and connected states. So connected states in Andhra, Kandukuri Veerashalingam Pantulu, Raghupati Venkatratnam Naidu, Desi Raju Pedavapaya. Okay. So like that we have to see all important social reformers. Gurjada Apparao. Gurjada Apparao. Country is not the soil but the people. Deshamante Matti Kadui. Deshamante Manushulu, like that. So Gurjada Apparao. Manchi Chedulanu Inchi Chudaga Manusalanduna Rindukulamulu. Manchi Annadi Malayeti, then Malane Gudun, like that. So he brought some changes in society. Okay. So don't believe in caste system. So untouchability should be avoided, like that he said, right? So all these important points you have to remember. So there is socio-religious renaissance movements, we can say 19th century, and concerned states also. India's freedom movement, revolutionaries in India and abroad. How these revolutionary movements that also started. So we have to see. India's freedom movement that we have to see. Freedom movement 1885 to 1947 important aspects we have to see. Moderate era, extremist era, Gandhian era that we have to see. Moderate era 1885 to 1905. 1905-1920 extremist era. Some said that Mahatma Gandhi started Champaran Satyagraha in 1917. That's why 1917. Up to 1917 only extremist era. Some said that no, Tilak lost life in 1920 till that time. Anyhow, 1920-1947 Gandhian era. So that we have to see freedom movement. Then revolutionaries we have to see. Revolutionaries. Bhagat Singh is a revolutionary. So Bhagat Singh, Rasguru, Sukhadev. So there is all these we have to see. Not only them are remaining. Chapekar brothers, revolutionaries only. They killed Rand. The British officer Rand was killed in the hands of Chapekar brothers, right? So like that, revolutionaries in India and abroad that. So then after we have to see this Mahatma Gandhi. Who called Gandhi Mahatma? So who called this Gandhi Mahatma? It is, okay, Rabindranath Tagore. Gandhi called this one as Gurudev. Okay, like that Mahatma Gandhi. So that's one area we have to see in this. Okay, so one area that we have to see Mahatma Gandhi. Okay, so after completion of his law, then he came to India. After that, he went to South Africa. In South Africa, he started an organization. Can you remember? Natal Indian Congress. An organization started by this one, Natal Indian Congress. What are the ashrams established by Gandhi in South Africa? Can you remember this one? What are the important ashrams? Two ashrams are established by this one. One is Phoenix, one is Tolstoy. Ashrams, they are established in South Africa. In India, one is Sabarmati Ashram, one is Wardha. Wardha comes in Maharashtra, Sabarmati comes in Gujarat, you know, well. Right, like that, we have to see this Mahatma Gandhi. So, Mahatma Gandhi's contribution that his thoughts, principles and philosophy imparted Satyagrahas. 1917 Champaran Satyagraha, 1918 Kheda Satyagraha, 1918 Ahmedabad Mill Workers Case, okay. So Mill Workers Strike, that is one. 1920 Non-Cooperation, 1922 Chauri Chaura Incident, okay. All important so things we have to see. Not only this is related with Gandhi, all important aspects. 1923 Swaraj Party, 1924 INC headed by Gandhi, Belgaum Session. 1925 CPA Party, 1927 Simon Commission that was established, but it came to India in 1928, right? 1930 Salt Satyagraha, that is also called Civil Disobedience Movement, you have to remember. Gandhi started this Civil Disobedience, that's one of them. Like that, there's all these we have to, philosophy is important, Satyagrahas, everything we have to. The role of Sardar Patel, Sardar Vallabhai Patel, the role of Sardar Vallabhai Patel, we can see. Okay, Sardar, he was called Sardar in 1928 in Bardoli Satyagraha. Bardoli Satyagraha, we are calling. Regarding this Bardoli Satyagraha, what happened? Bardoli comes in Gujarat. Okay, taxes were hiked by the British Raj at this moment. So, this Sardar Vallabhai Patel became leader for that incident. Okay, there only people called him Sardar. Sardar means great leader. Okay, like that, Sardar Vallabhai Patel. Then we have to see Subhash Chandra Bose, S.C. Bose, Ajad Hind Fauj, that was started by Subhash Chandra Bose. Originally, INA, Indian National Army, that was started by Mohan Singh and Niranjan Gill. They handed over this to Ras Bihari Ghosh, then Subhash Chandra Bose. Subhash Chandra Bose became leader and he named this one as Ajad Hind Fauj. Two training centers are established by this one. One is at Singapore, one is at Burma, Rangoon. So like that, regiments are established by Subhash Chandra Bose. Indian Struggle, that is the autobiography of Subhash Chandra Bose. Indian Struggle, okay. So like that, so all important points. Freedom movement and post-independence consolidation that also. We have to see this Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, that is one of the important areas. We have to see what contribution of this man. So, we have to see Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, his life contribution to making of Indian Constitution. That's why only he was called Father of Indian Constitution. to frame, to draft Indian Constitution, you know, it took 2 years, 11 months and 18 days. At last, it came into force on 26 January 1950. The contribution of Sir Dr. Des, especially B.R. Ambedkar, Bhim Rao, Ramji Ambedkar, belongs to Mahakaste. Okay, so Des contributed a lot to abolish this untouchability. At last, embraced Buddhism. You see, so Dr. B.R. Ambedkar at last embraced Buddhism, right? Like that. So I had to see all this. India after independence, reorganization of states of India, reorganization, SRC that was appointed, SRC, States Reorganization Commission. That is in the year 1953, that is on December 22nd only, this SRC was, okay. So SRC came into force, we can say. Chairperson Fazal Ali, that's why it is also called Fazal Ali Commission. And H.N. Kunjru, Hrudayanath Kunjru, one of the members. K.M. Fanikar, Kavalam Madhav Fanikar, he is also one of the members in this SRC. Chairperson Fazal Ali Commission. Like that, we have to see all these important areas for prelims. Okay, so you have to prepare well for this group and prelims examination. That is all in your hands only. You are the guide, you are the master, you are the pilot. Wherever you want to take your life, you can take your life. It all depends on your energies, your capacity, your caliber, your hardware, your intelligence, all these. Okay, so I already told you, intelligence may fail sometimes, but hard work never fails. So that's why I concentrate well on this. Okay, so definitely you will get success in the examination. Okay, you go to Play Store and download Amrita IAS Academy app. Okay, you are going to get all the things, whatever we upload. We are going to see them, right? Thank you.